Stanford University.
The Tibetan regions of western Sichuan are high elevation areas on the Himalayan plateau. They're inhabited by poor Tibetan pig farmers. These people live in small villages and they have free-range pigs. They don't have toilets, so oftentimes they will go out into the fields and defecate there, which means that the pigs are actually running around in areas where there's readily human stool available to eat. So this puts this area at high risk for tinnitus oleum, which is the pork tapeworm. When people eat undercooked pork, the tapeworm develops in their GI tract. And that means that person then sheds thousands and thousands of eggs in their stool. Those eggs then contaminate the environment and are eaten by the pig, which causes the pig to get the tapeworm, which it then passes back to people. Once it gets into the brain, it causes a wide spectrum of disease. All developing countries that have small-scale pig farming have this disease. It was our theory, our hypothesis, that children were especially vulnerable to this disease, mainly because here was a parasite that was getting in children's brains during a sort of a formative time in their lives. So what we did is we went into three counties in western Sichuan and we surveyed all fifth and sixth graders in those counties. What we found was that disease in these schools was highly prevalent. You know, in some schools up to 22% of kids had evidence in their blood that they had the disease. If you imagine kids dropping out of school from this disease, that could actually enforce a cycle of poverty in these already poor communities. We have a vaccine that is effective in pigs. We have treatment that we can give to pigs that will kill the parasite while it's in the pig. We know how to install hygiene stations at schools. We know how to design behavioral change in schools. So if we took all of these things and we could get them into the field in a cost-effective way, we could really decrease the burden of this disease.